This is Padma Dharani, speech language pathologist. Welcome to Born to Win, Padma Dharani. Are you worried that your child is not able to speak even after lots of sincere efforts from your side? Do you think that you are stressing your child too much to talk? Stressing or forcing your child will not make them to learn faster. Instead, it will make them to learn very slowly because they will be least interested in what you teach. So in order to make them interested, you should do in such a way that you are attracted towards your sound, attracted towards the activities, and it should be fun related also. There are many studies done in this area. It says that indirect language stimulation increases the child's vocabulary, intelligibility, and also the socialization skills. With the help of self and parallel talk, the parent can provide the role model to the child so that the child gets exposure to that language and later on the child can imitate. This method doesn't pressure the child to provide a response. Instead, the adult has to use very simple and very short sentences to describe each action or each object while interacting with the child. So, this will help the child to learn the language and which he or she may use it later on in their life. Today, I'm going to share 6 ideas of how to indirectly stimulate your child's language development. These ideas will definitely help your child to learn faster because in these techniques, you are not forcing your child to learn something. You're just making your child to sit in a place and listen to what you do. If you haven't subscribed my videos yet, please go and subscribe and don't forget to press the bell button. And if you like this video, press the like button and share it with all the parents. Let's move on to the video. First method is self-talk. In this method, you're going to talk for your child and you're not going to involve your child for talking. Or you're not forcing your child to talk. So instead of telling, see, this is yellow cup and keeping it here, you're not telling anything to your child and you're just keeping it here. Yellow cup, wow, super. Then I'm placing the blue cup. Up, 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 up. Then green cup, up, 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 up. Then red color, up, 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 up. Wow, so nice. Then I'm going to keep it down. Down, 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 down. Down, 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 down. Down, 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 down. That's it. You're just doing this activity and your child is listening to it. That's it. You're not forcing your child to do anything and you're not teaching them colors, you're not teaching them up, you're not teaching them down. So in this method, your child is just observing you and in future, your child may definitely do this activity. Second method is parallel talk. In this method, you're talking on behalf of your child. In self-talk, you just talk for your child. Now in this method, you're talking on behalf of your child. So what you're going to do is, suppose if your child is having this elephant and move it like this. You just have to say, go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Wow, it's gone. Now, let's take the cow. Here is the cow. Your child is moving the cow. You're not moving the cow. Your child is moving. So, I'm just demonstrating it. And if your child is moving this cow, just say, moo. Cow says moo. Cow is moving. Gone, gone, gone. Cow has gone. Now, next comes the horse. If a child takes a horse, say, next comes the horse. Horse moves like this. So, in this way, you are pairing a meaning to the action. So, you are giving meaning to those actions. So, the child will understand that this is the meaning of go. This is cow. This is horse. And this is an elephant. So, you are giving a meaning also. At the same time, you are not forcing your child to say cow, go or anything. You are not even telling him this is a cow. You are just talking on behalf of your child. So this is the difference between the self-talk and the parallel talk. You always give meaning to it and in self-talk you give meaning to what you did. Now in parallel talk you are giving meaning to what your child is doing. So this is the main difference between both the techniques. Step is expansion.
In this method, you are not telling your child to speak in sentences. You are just expanding your child's utterance. Suppose if you show him this card, if your child says, boy, brush, you have to say it as, oh, boy is brushing. That's it. Then you keep this card. And you show one more picture. And if your child says, boy, eat, you should say, good, the boy is eating. And then you keep this card. You are not telling your child, say, the boy is eating. Instead, you are telling, the boy is eating. Then one more thing is, if you show this card and your child says, boy sleep, you should expand it as, the boy is sleeping. And you should say, wow, very good. So in this way, you can expand your child's utterances. In the same way, you are not forcing your child or stressing him too much to build his language. Fourth method is expansion plus. What is expansion plus? In expansion method, you just expanded the child's utterances. Here in expansion plus, you are adding one more word at the end of the word, at the end of the child's utterance. So here how I'll explain you now. Suppose if you show this card and say, and if your child says orange, you should say, yes, this is an orange. Orange is yummy. So in this way, you can add one more sentence to your child's utterances. And next one, if you show this to your child and if your child says this apple, you should say, yes, this is an apple. Apple is red in color. Okay, I think you must have understood this technique. And finally, if you show this card and ask your child, and if your child says the dog, you should say, yes, this is a dog. Dog says, bow bow. So in this way, you can add one more sentence to your child's utterances. Your child will learn how to speak in two sentences. Fifth method is description. In this method, you are just describing your child's utterance. If your child says, this is an elephant, you have to explain more, like, elephant has four legs. It has a long tusk. It has two big ears. It is black in color. It is a huge elephant. It is a huge animal. So you can explain the child's utterances so that the child will learn everything about this elephant. Suppose if you show this to your child and if your child says this is banana, you should describe this banana by saying, wow, very good. This is banana. Banana is yellow in color. It is long in shape. You can peel this and eat. Banana is yummy. In this way, you can explain or describe your child's utterances in order to increase their vocabulary. And the last one, sixth one, is recast. What is recast? Recast is nothing but reframing the sentence into a correct grammatical form. If your child has grammatical error, you can correct the grammatical errors. Suppose if your child says the dog bark, you can change it as the dog is barking. If your child says go out, and you can change it as I have to go out. So in this way, it can be used only for correcting the grammatical errors in the sentences. All these techniques cannot be used for all the children. You should pick up the technique depending on the child's vocabulary level. If your child is at very low level, you can use self-talk and parallel talk. And if your child is at good at language, you can use the last one, recast. So similarly, you can choose any of the techniques depending on your child's level. Dear parents, today we saw 6 techniques to develop your child's language skills indirectly. So first technique is self-talk, then parallel talk, then expansion plus description and recast. So all these 6 methods cannot be used for a child at a time. And it cannot be used for all the children. You have to select the particular technique depending on your child's vocabulary. And you should need at least 10 to 15 minutes of time every day to spend with your child. Only then your child will start listening to you and they will understand you are teaching something to your child and they have to replicate the same thing. So spend some 10 to 15 minutes per day and your child will not improve immediately. It It will require at least 2 to 3 months of practice for your child to come on its own. So, start sparing time with your children and explore new things every day. And meet you again in another video. Until then, it is bye-bye from Padma Dharani.